October 17th, 2017. An aerial image taken over an island 235 miles from the coast of Indonesia captures something strange in the waters below.
Wow, these are just pristine, beautiful blue waters. And then something has turned the water red. This is very frightening. It looks like there's blood filling the water.
The image reminds biologist Haley Chamberlain of a disturbing event she has witnessed on other islands 7,500 miles away.
In the Danish Faroe Islands, every year there is a slaughter of pilot whales. As you can imagine, it's going to turn whatever ocean color you have into a red, bloody mess.
The hunt, known locally as the Grundedraw, dates to the 13th century.
It's significant to them, not only on the level of tradition and being able to sustain themselves, but also to be able to support themselves economically.
Historians calculate that at the peak of the whaling industry during the 1840s, there were more than 900 ships on the world's oceans hunting the marine mammals.
The oil from the whale's blubber was used in lamps, soaps, and candles, and the bones were actually used to make umbrellas, whips, and even ladies' corsets.
Today, the Faroese only hunt the whales for their meat, which is divided up among the local population by the chief of police.
The practice is highly controversial, but the Faroe Islanders will argue that it's tradition and they're not letting any of the animal go to waste. That said, it doesn't make it any easier to watch.
Experts speculate that the crimson tide in this image could be similar evidence of a mass slaughter.
Globally, whaling is not just going on in the Faroe Islands. So could this be something that we're seeing here? Could this be a whaling event?
Yet when investigator Kiki Sanford consults geographical records of the area, she discovers this theory doesn't stack up.
We know this is Christmas Island, which is within the Australian territory, and the Australians are anti-whaling, so the likelihood of it being whaling is really slim.
When experts uncover more images of the weird phenomenon, the mystery of the crimson tide deepens.
It's coming out of the ocean and onto land.
Whatever this red mass is, it's moving. It's alive.
Biologist Stephanie Shuttler has a theory for the mysterious moving red mass.
Perhaps what we're looking at here is a migration.
Shuttler believes the aerial images have captured a bizarre event that sounds straight out of a 1950s horror movie. An invasion of millions upon millions of crabs.
It's like a moving red carpet, a marching army of crabs.
The story of the weird invasion begins several weeks earlier, in the woods in the center of the island.
For most of the year, they live quietly deep in the forest. But all at once, in conjunction with the lunar cycle, these crabs move in mass migration to the ocean.
The 50 million strong crab army's sidestepping march to the waters of the Indian Ocean is driven by one thing. Sex.
As far as the eye can see, it's crabs. There's crabs.
For the islanders, it's crabageddon.
It causes absolute chaos. The whole island is brought to a standstill. There's not much they can do except for wait for the crabs to do their thing and leave.
Once they've traveled across the island to the beach, the males dig love nests in the sand and prepare to get their claws into the females.
It's one of the weirdest and most awe-inspiring sights in nature.
A single female crab lays up to 100,000 eggs in the ocean. Juveniles emerge from the sea like a red swarming tsunami, a phenomenon captured as never before by eyes in the sky.
It's such a beautiful biological event.
Yet today, the crab army is under attack from an even more gigantic mega swarm.
These crabs have been doing this for eons on this island, but now there's a problem.
with an invasive species called the yellow crazy ant.
And this alien species carries a crab-killing superweapon, projectile formic acid.
The ants spit corrosive acid.
The crabs are blinded by the formic acid, and not being able to see, they will die of starvation and dehydration. And then the ants will come and eat the dead bodies.
Biologists have tried to rid the island of the acid-spitting terrors. But the killer insects always seem to be six steps ahead.
If the ants are allowed to continue their reign of terror on Christmas Island unabated, then the island's crabs will be totally wiped out.